कमनप्रीत कौर एंड आई एम अ बीकॉम ऑनर्स फ्रेश ग्रेजुएट फ्रॉम गुरु गोबिंद सिंह कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई विल बी परस्यूइंग माय पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टडीज इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट एट सेनेका कॉलेज ऑफ अप्लाइड आर्ट्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. इट इज इन टोरंटो कैनेडा.
So I think जो पहला क्वेश्चन आता है, the you know the very first sort of thing that occurs to my mind is why Canada, right? So you're studying in Delhi University, become honors is your program. Why did you choose to you know apply to this country and for this particular course?
See, I believe that Canada is one of the safest countries in the world for international students. It welcomes them with open arms, and quality of life, quality of education is really good here. And most important factor that Canadian universities and colleges are relatively cheaper in comparison to other countries like US and UK. So that's why I have chosen Canada.
Okay. And what are your long-term plans? Do you want to go work for a while and come back, or are you looking to settle down in Canada?
No, I will work. Like I will do 1+1 program.
Okay.
Then I'll apply for my postgraduate work permit, and then you know I'll work full time. Will save some money and then apply for my master's later on.
All right.
So this is my plan as of now.
All right. So my understanding is that you're doing the 1+1 program because it gives you more time for that work permit, right?
Yes.
A little more.
If you are doing a course, like if the course duration is 1 year, then you get a work permit for 1 year only. But if the course duration is 2 years, then we get a work permit for 3 years.
Okay. And
so, like most of the postgraduate diplomas are of 1 year only. So I had to opt for another program. It's not a complete 2 year program, but it will be 1+1.
Okay. So currently you're enrolled into one PG diploma.
Yes.
Resource management, and plan is to eventually do one year postgraduate diploma, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So tell me how you chose this particular program, because studying in Canada, I think is an obvious choice. You want to settle down there. You want to study a course that allows you to find a work permit. But how do you choose which course to study?
See, while learning about different foundations of business subjects like accounts, finance, human resource, international business management, you know, we had a lot of subjects in during our graduation years. So I came to connect with my inner passion to become a human resource professional. And then I researched about it and I got to know that human resource, that like this is one of the better paid sectors in Canada. Even post-pandemic period and due to people working remotely, HR professionals, the demand for HRs has increased, be it recruiters or HR executives, HR managers, anyone in the field. That is why.
All right. So you're saying it was a natural sort of follow through with your program in commerce, and additionally, it's a field that has plenty of prospects, right?
Yes.
In Canada. All right. That makes sense. So once you decided that, you know, you're going to apply to Canada, what colleges did you consider? Which ones did you consider?
Okay. So I wanted to come to Toronto, either Toronto or in the entire Ontario. Like I wanted to go to Ontario. So I applied for 2 to 3 colleges of Toronto, like Humber College. Then we have a Conestoga College in Kitchener.
Mm-hmm.
And the Seneca College, that's it. I got LOA from Seneca within just 8 to 9 days of when I applied, and then I followed up the procedure. Like I was given a time period of 30 days to pay the first semester fee.
Okay.
Yeah, and then.
Okay. What are your plans about funding your education? Because I mean, maybe you could tell us how much your program tuition costs are like, and what are your plans to fund the education.
Okay, so in my case, it is an 8-month program with 4 months of co-op semester. So
right.
Co-op is just like an internship in our field of education. So for these 8 months, I have paid around 9.5 lakhs for these 8 months, and this was entirely financed by my father.
Okay.
Okay, and then for the next year, the fee will be around same. For postgraduate diploma, be it any university, it costs around 9 to 12 lakhs.
Okay.
Okay, plus our GIC amount, which is around $10,200.
Right.
Okay, and then other miscellaneous expenses like our tickets, the stuff that we are going to carry there. So it entire cost is around 17 to 18 lakhs for right. 1 year.
Right. So if you're looking to study in Canada for a year, that's the number that you're looking at, about 17 lakhs in overall terms, right? You must have done your research about the co-op term as well as part-time jobs. So maybe you could tell us something about what your research told you.
Okay, so I researched about the co-op term. Like, it is an internship. It can be paid or unpaid, but at least it will give you some Canadian experience.
Right.
When we are coming to Canada, we do not have any Canadian experience. We are just carrying out the experience from our home country that is not so like countable.
Sure.
So this 4 months of Canadian experience can give you an edge over others. Like, it can add to your CV. So it can create a good impression on employers. And also you can work full time in those 4 months of co-op semester. But in my case, this was optional. Like, we have optional work term. It is not mandatory. Mm-hmm. If I do not opt for co-op, then also I will get the degree without it.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And for part-time jobs, it's like we can work 20 hours per week during our studies. And after 8 months, after this 8 months, I'll be given 4 months. Like, it will be a break. Mm-hmm. Where I'll be doing a co-op also, and then my part-time job also.
Okay.
If I will not opt for co-op, then I can work for part-time, like for full-time, not part-time. Like, I can work for full-time. That is 40 hours per week.
Okay. Help me understand when you started the process of applications, because my understanding is that you're going to join in the winter intake, right?
Yeah.
So you're going into the Jan intake 2022, whereas most candidates right now are looking at the September 2022 intake, right? For a student to understand this better, how much time does it take from when you decide to apply all the way till creating the applications and submitting all of that? What's the time frame that one should look at?
September intake, which is known as the fall intake, it is the main intake in which 100% of the programs are open in every college and university.
Sure.
This figure comes down to 70 to 80% in Jan intake, and then in May intake, only 40 to 50% of the courses are available.
Sure.
Fine. Initially, I applied for September intake, but then I had to defer the intake to winter intake due to some reasons. I graduated in July 2021, this year only.
Right.
And I had to apply for a visa. So for that, I needed three years, my transcripts. But due to some reasons, like due to COVID or something, we could not get the results on time. So I deferred the intake.
Right.
I started with my application procedure in January 2021.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Then I told you that within 8 days, I got my LOA. Then I was given a time period of 30 days to prepare to pay my first semester fee.
Right.
I paid the fee and then I appeared for my medicals. And then other process. So I paid the second semester fee and my GIC in around June 2021.
Okay.
I think if you are planning to go to Canada, then you should start preparing like 7 to 8 months before,
right,
before intake starts.
Correct. So the September intake or the fall intake 2022 opens up in the middle of this month, so 15th of October. So if you're watching this video, I think you need to get your plans in place. Maybe reach out to us, and we'll surely help you out. All right. Coming back to Canada, when you decided to apply to Canada, surely you must have considered the various kinds of courses available, right? One can actually very easily get confused because there are master's programs and there are postgraduate diplomas and then there are postgraduate certificate courses, right? So when you decided to do, you know, to pursue a program in HR, which course did you choose? And I mean, why did you choose, you know, the postgraduate certificate or postgraduate diploma course?
All right. Initially, I wanted to go to Canada for my master's, but as most of the Canadian universities, I would not say most, like 95 to 96% of the Canadian universities do not accept 3-year undergraduate degrees. So to cover up this, like to complete my education of 4 years, I had to, I was clear by the time that I have to pursue my postgraduate diploma, which is of 1 year. So difference between PGDM and master's, obviously these both are same on the, if we talk about academic level, postgraduate diploma and master's, they have the same academic level, but I would say master's is comparatively really expensive as compared to PGDM. Like if I say for 1 year, the cost of doing PGDM is around 9 to 12 lakhs, while it is around 15 to 20 lakhs for master's.
Right.
And second, we cannot do a master's degree when we are having a undergraduate degree for 3 years. We cannot pursue master's. Third, obviously master's is a higher degree because it contains 180 credit points in our PR, while it is just 120 credit points in postgraduate diploma.
Right.
And that's it. That is the major difference. Obviously, the one who has done master's is considered as highly qualified as compared to the one who has done a postgraduate diploma.
Right. So my understanding is that most of these master's courses are usually offered by the top universities in Canada, whereas the postgraduate diploma program, yeah, are offered by standalone colleges, necessarily a university, right? So
yeah,
is that if you're applying for these postgraduate diploma courses, you have many, many more options. And like you very rightly pointed out, the admission requirements might not be as stringent.
Yeah, in fact, for masters, they require more IELTS score as compared to a postgraduate diploma. Mm-hmm. Also, your academic profile should be very strong if you're going for master's.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the master's program even count your experience also.
Right. Okay. So when you were, I mean, let's come back to, you know, the course that you applied to, the postgraduate diploma. What were the admission requirements? What all did you have to furnish at the time of, you know, applying to Seneca?
Okay. I applied in SDS category. We have two categories to apply, SDS and non-SDS.
Right.
SDS is student direct stream. Mm-hmm. So if you're applying in SDS category, if the student profile is really good, then you should go for SDS. If the student profile is not that good, then just go for non-SDS. But in non-SDS category, the chances for visa approval are like 50-50.
Okay.
You may or may not get the visa. Mm-hmm. So in my case, or in most of the Canadian colleges, it's 6.5 bands overall with no less than 6.
That's the IELTS score.
IELTS score for postgraduate diploma.
Right.
While for normal diplomas, they even accept overall 6 bands with 5.5 in any of the module. They do accept that.
Sure.
So it was, if I come to the academic profile, then it is minimum 60% in graduation.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Or in class 12th, if you're going for a normal diploma.
Okay.
Well, that's it. This was the academic requirement.
Right. Just your, college academic.
One most important thing was that your program, the program that you are choosing, must match your field. Because there were many rejections in past 2 to 3 months due to this reason, that suppose a student who has done commerce was going for arts, humanities field, very low profile field. So your course must not be low profile. If you are a master's in India and you're going for a PGDM in Canada, then also your visa may get rejected.
Right.
So.
Right. Ideally, choose a program that is within the field that you've studied in, and should be a higher degree, right?
Higher degree or equivalent degree, but not low.
All right. So okay, so those are the admission requirements according to you. All right, so I mean, I think we've almost entirely understood your journey. So when is it that you leave for Seneca?
Well, I leave for Seneca in December 2021, this year only, because my classes will begin from 10th of January.
Okay.
So I'll be leaving like 10 to 15 days prior.
Okay. And does the college also provide you accommodation, or are you going to fend for that yourself?
Yeah, I'm going to do it myself. But yes, Seneca does provide accommodations to the students.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and I think the cost is around 8 to 9 lakhs for eight months.
Okay.
It's really high. So that's why I'll go for some private rooms.
Okay. So, you know, just before we sort of close out this discussion, I wanted to ask you, what are your views about, you know, our approach to admissions? Because we believe that the smart way of applying to Canada, and in fact any foreign country, is to first connect with mentors who can guide you. So what are your views on the same, and how do you believe you can help, you know, future students?
Okay, so I believe that students should not entirely depend on their agents.
Mm-hmm.
Like, agents will guide them on the basis of their, like, on the basis of things that they prefer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you are connecting students with other students or other professionals who are in the same field of education. Like, if somebody is watching this video and wants to, then they can directly come to me.
Okay.
So that is a very important thing for students. So this approach is quite good as compared to other agents who just tell only specific list of courses and specific list of colleges to the students to apply.
Right.
So this should not be done.
Right. So it's better to consult a mentor, because you get more
exactly
information about courses, about jobs, about you know, life in Canada.
Obviously, yes.
All right. Thanks for your time, Damanpreet. We wish you the very best of luck with your journey at Seneca College. And we hope that you stay connected with us.
Thank you so much, sir.